It has been suggested that in women who have persistently thin uterine lining or who have experienced multiple failed embryo transfers, giving them a treatment known as G-CSF before embryo transfer may improve their chances for IVF success. There is a scientific theory that injecting G-CSF into the uterine cavity may increase IVF success by helping to thicken the uterine lining or by increasing the chance for an embryo to implant and produce a pregnancy. Does it really work? What does the science say? Stay tuned. G-CSF is an abbreviation for Granulocyte Colony Stimulating Factor. You may also hear it referred to as Leucostim or Filgrastim. G-CSF is a type of growth factor that stimulates bone marrow to produce certain types of white blood cells. In the uterine lining, G-CSF promotes regenerative activity of the cells and helps in increasing the blood supply. When we look at the studies that have used G-CSF in IVF, we find two things. One is that the overall quality of these studies was not very good, and two, some studies appear to show a benefit and others did not. If you are a subscriber to Infertility TV, you know that whenever we have a situation when there are lots of small studies with conflicting results, we go looking for a meta-analysis. A meta-analysis combines the results from a bunch of smaller studies into one larger study to improve the chances of finding an accurate result. We found this meta-analysis of 13 studies involving 522 women who received G-CSF and 520 women who received a placebo or no additional treatment during IVF. There was some pretty advanced statistical analysis here, which I won't bore you with. What was the bottom line? There were three different questions that this meta-analysis attempted to answer. Question number one, does G-CSF help thicken the uterine lining? This analysis was unable to find any benefit to making the uterine lining thicker. Question two, did G-CSF improve the chances for becoming pregnant, having an ongoing pregnancy, or a live birth? No, no, and no. What about couples who had had two or more previous failed embryo transfers? Also no. Question number three, did G-CSF lower the risk for miscarriage? Finally, no. Based on the results of these 13 studies, it does not appear that G-CSF is helpful. However, at about the same time that this meta-analysis was published, another study was published looking at G-CSF. This study was larger than any of the studies in the meta-analysis, so the results could potentially change the results. The quality of this study was also much better than most of the other studies. This study looked at couples with recurrent implantation failure. That is, the failure to achieve a clinical pregnancy after the transfer of at least four good quality embryos in a minimum of three fresh or frozen cycles to a woman under the age of 40 years. 82 women received G-CSF and the rest just had saline, which is salt water. The patients did not know who received the G-CSF and who got the placebo. When they looked at the results, they found that G-CSF patients did not have a better pregnancy rate or live birth rate. There was no difference in the risk for miscarriage, and the uterine lining wasn't any thicker. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. At the current time, the best scientific evidence does not support the use of G-CSF to thicken the uterine lining or improve IVF success. If you want to enroll in a study, that's fine, but you should not be charged for treatment until it can be proven that there is a benefit. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.